Hi, in this video tutorial, you're going to learn about the Scratch editor. As you get started with Scratch, you will need to feel comfortable using the different tools and sections to build your game. In this video, you're going to learn about the stage, the blocks palette, the scripts area, the sprites list, and the backdrop tool. Let's get started. When you visit the Scratch website, which is scratch.mit.edu, and you click on Create a Project, you'll see the Scratch Project Editor. Let's review the main sections together to help you get started. The stage is where the action of your code takes place. As an example, I'm going to add a few code blocks to my project. I'm going to add a when green flag clicked, move 10 steps, and play meow sound until done. Now, when I click on the green flag, the action will happen inside the stage. Let's take a look. That's great. My cat just moved 10 steps to the right and made a meow sound. The stage has three different sizes: small, medium, and full screen. We recommend that you work with the medium size while you develop your project. When you're ready to test your game, you can switch into full screen mode, which lets you see all your graphics a little bit larger. The blocks palette is the area that contains all the Scratch code blocks you can add. You'll find that they're color-coded based on their category. For instance, motion blocks move sprites. I've got a move 10 steps code block here. Looks blocks change the appearance of a sprite. For example, let's add a say hello code block at the very end. And there we go, it actually changed how the sprite looks on stage. Sound blocks help you play sounds, and so on. Spend some time exploring all the possible code blocks you can add. You'll also be completing some online tutorials to help you learn how to program with Scratch. The scripts area is where you add blocks to run your code. In this case, we've already added a few code blocks to the section. Since we have a when green flag clicked code block at the top, the action will take place every time we click on the green flag button. But we can also click the code blocks to run the code. Notice that everything we do affects the character that we have on stage. In Scratch, this is called a sprite. Our sprite list below contains all the sprites or characters that we have. We can easily add a new one from the library by clicking on the Choose a Sprite button. We have a bunch of sprites that are already created for us by the Scratch team. I'm going to choose the bat. Note that when I add a new sprite, all of our previous code blocks disappear. That's because each sprite gets its own code blocks. I can select my cat sprite again to see the code blocks we added before. If you want to add a new sprite that you've designed, you can also upload an image from your computer to bring it into your game. We can rename each sprite and also resize them, like so. You'll notice that each sprite has three tabs: code, costumes, and sounds. Let's review each one. The code tab shows all the code blocks that we've added for a specific sprite. For the bat sprite, I'm going to add when green flag clicked, repeat 30 times an action, and that action is going to be switching to the next costume. Now, if I run it, it looks like my bat is flying. You might be wondering what is happening here. Well, if I click on the bat sprite and I click on the costumes tab, I can see that this sprite actually has four different costumes or versions of itself. The costumes tab lets us modify sprites and add several versions of them that we can cycle through. The sounds tab lets us modify and add sounds that sprites make. The famous Scratch cat makes a meow sound by default. We can make that meow sound go faster or slower. We can even reverse that sound altogether. Finally, our backdrop selector tool, found in the bottom right corner, lets us modify the backdrops we add to our stage. You can choose one you like from the Scratch library, or you can upload your own. In this case, I'm going to search for a city backdrop. There we go. And now when I run it, it looks like these characters actually live somewhere. Finally, in addition to the scratch sections we just covered, the main menu at the top lets you change your language, save your project, complete some of the interactive tutorials, name your project, and share your project with others. Now that you have a good idea of how the Scratch editor works, we recommend that you complete a few of the online tutorials before moving on to create your own game. This will help you build confidence with all the possible things you can do in Scratch. Have fun programming with your engineering team, and we can't wait to see what you'll build.